cover the invisible system. In particular, during my presentation, I will go through these following points. First of all, I would like to introduce you with the context, mainly underline which is the exact meaning of business ecosystem and business model. Then, very briefly, because Servette has just introduced what is the main purpose of iCargo, I will explain you the main features and the main important point of iCargo that allows us to go deeply into the detail of the approach. This approach is quite innovative because consider the business model as not a static concept, but it will concentrate on the evolution of the business model. And we will see how this evolution of the involved of the business model of the involved partner will impact on the iCargo business ecosystem. I will also show you an example directly taken from the iCargo project, and then if we have enough time also we can go through the approach with a general example with a general company. So first of all, as I said, the core concept of this presentation is the business model and business ecosystem. Business ecosystem is not a new concept, but is becoming more and more prominent in the market, as for example Amazon or Apple. It was introduced by Moore in 1996, but what is a business ecosystem? We can define it as an intentional community of different economic actors. This actor have in common protocols to communicate, interfaces, and an overall business goal. In particular, now we are focusing on the business model of the different actors involved in this business ecosystem. The business model are used as a very as a tool to support the manager to define the situation of a company. Very often, the business model is a static. Usually, if I have to draw the business model of my company, I have a set of questions and I have to answer to this question in order to describe the current situation. So, for example, describe the key activity, the value proposition. But what about if in my market I have an innovation that will change and impact very significantly my business? In this case, we will concentrate on the evolution of the business model of the company. And so the approach that we are proposing is right focused on this point, to study the evolution of the business model within a business ecosystem. So the business ecosystem that we are referring to is the ecosystem of iCargo. So very briefly, as Servette said, many iCargo want to focus in advance and extend the ICT services for the logistic supply chain. Of course, improving the logistic performances, but at the same time concentrating also on the reduction of the carbon footprint. In this ecosystem, we have to describe the actors that are involved. And for this reason, we prepare an ideal representation of the different actors that are involved in the ecosystem. This is a representation of what we call the iCargo reference value chain. The value chain represents the relationship between the different actors of the ecosystem, and all the relationships represent value creation links. In terms that the suppliers must provide a service with an adequate measure of value for the customer. Of course, also to be sustainable in market terms. But let's see in the detail the different involved actors. We have three user roles in the ecosystem. That are the logistics service client, also called LSC, the freight service integrator, also called FSI, the logistics service provider, LSP. Then we have three supporting roles, that are the information service integrator, ISI, the transportation network manager, TNM, and the transport regulator, TR. Looking at these are the, this is the representation of the ICAO reference value chain. In the first line, we can see the three user roles. On the left part, we have the logistics service client, the freight service integrator, and the logistics service provider. In this role, we have the additional role of the reference value chain. In particular, the LSC has a need to deliver the goods from an origin to a destination, but some particular constraints. Of course, good logistic performances, no extra cost, and also looking at the environmental emissions. Then the freight service integrator that organizes the logistic service needs to organize the door-to-door service in order to fulfill the request of the LSC. Finally, the LSP has to provide the transport service and wants that this service can be reached by the logistic service client. I introduce these roles because they are very important to specify better the approach that I'm proposing now. This is the core part of the presentation, and so I will tell you the first features of this approach. The starting point is a well-known canvas proposed by Osterwalder. This canvas is very simple because it offers 9 basic blocks to describe the business model of a company. The goal of this approach, as I said, is to study the evolution of a business model and to find out in a systematic and well-structured way how the impact of iCargo can be on the current business model of the involved partner. So, these are the main steps of the approach. First of all, referring to the role that I have just mentioned, the LSC, FSI, LSP, and ASI, we collect the description of the current business model. So, we are finding out how is the situation today. So, which are the business model of the involved actors? Then, we recall an important concept, the jobs to be done. Mainly, a job to be done is a new need that has to be satisfied in particular circumstances. In the concept of iCargo, we can call the jobs to be done as business and technical innovation. So, these are the business and technical innovation introduced in iCargo. And we would like to map the impact of this innovation on the business model at the current state. To do this, we have created a template, and the result of this template are what we call a reference business model. They represent the description of the possible profile, future profiles of the actors involved. Finally, we draw this new profile into the iCargo system in order to show how the different roles of the reference value chain can evolve in the iCargo ecosystem. So, let's take the first point. We consider the actors that currently are on the market. This is the reason why we didn't consider the additional role related to the management of the network and to the regulation, because currently they are not a position on the market. So we take the logistics service client, the freight service integrator, the logistics service provider, and the information service integrator, and we collected the business model by using the canvas proposed by Osterwalder. Osterwalder proposed, as I said, 9 different blocks. The first one is the value proposition. So each company has to describe in which term they are offering values to their customer. They describe the key activities and the key resources used to reach these values, the partnership that they have, and if they have partnership and the relationship with customers, and the channel to reach the customers. And the customer segment describes the needs that they are addressing with their products. And then there is the cost structure and the revenues coming from the product that they are offering on the market. This canvas is a well-known tool and is useful for us to describe the current situation. Then, have different colors, we can have different results. The simpler one, the simplest one is no change. So this particular innovation is not impacting on this specific part of the business model, so the situation will not change. Then we can have a situation of change. This means that the business model stays as it is. So we don't have drastic change in the business model. We can have only some improvement brought by Ecargo. Then we have the possibility of an opportunity. This is a strategic opportunity that really changed the business model and let the companies to cover a different position in the market. It's not mapped here, but we can have the case in which the opportunity is not reached by the company. In this case, we will have a disruption. That means that the company, if it stays in the current situation, it is not able to stay in the market anymore. So going to the other point, this template allows us to find out the different effects of the innovation brought by Ecargo. At the same time, we can relate these effects to build new business models. And this new business model are what we call the reference business model. For then we will see an example related to LSC. At this point, when we have defined the different reference business model, we are able to represent the possible evolution of the role of Ecargo in the Ecargo ecosystem. Let's see. This is the Ecargo ecosystem, the future Ecargo ecosystem. In the first picture that I showed you, we have the Ecargo reference value chain. In this part, we have the logistics service client. In this part, the freight service integrator and the logistics service provider. The first line, as in the first picture that I show you, represents the user roles of the Ecargo reference value chain. And here, we have the supporting role of the Ecargo reference value chain. In each rectangle, I represented how the different role can evolve by the effect of Ecargo project. For example, the logistics service client, we analyzed deeply into the retailer and the manufacturer. We found out that we can have only an improved profile of this figure because they comes from the part related only to the changes. So no substantial change in the business ecosystem, only improved. And we have what we said, enhanced the retailer and enhanced the manufacturer. Then we have some profiles that are deeply involved and impacted by the cargo. And these are the retailer that now are focused on the environmental part. And also the retailer that focus the business of the e-commerce. Above the logistics service provider, at the same thing, we have the enhanced logistics service provider. The logistics service provider focuses on the environmental part, and the logistics service provider that are able to offer added value services. For example, foreseeing monitoring capability, dynamic planning capability coming directly from Ecargo. About the FSI, I will explain you the detail afterwards because I would like to concentrate on this profile. And then we have the ISI. That is the key part of this ecosystem because the software other vendor currently will evolve in the company that offer functionalities as a service in the market, the monitor infrastructure provider, and the connectivity infrastructure provider. Then I would like to show you directly an example. This is the picture that we saw some minutes before. The example is related to the logistics service client. This is the current business model of the logistics service client that is mainly focused on the competition based on price, position on the market, and the service offered. These are the Ecargo jobs, so the innovation brought by Ecargo for the LSC. the impact of these jobs on the business model, we found out three possible reference business models. As I said, we can have the enhanced retailers that are only an improved profile of the retailers. Then we can have the so-called green retailers, the one focused on the environmental issues, and the e-commerce retailers, ones that exploit the collaboration to sell the product directly online to new customers, because in these terms they are able to reach also new customers on the market. By looking at the FSIs, it's quite interesting, because we have some profiles that have only an improvement, some profiles that, that derives from a disruption, and a new profile. The asset-bound FSI are the freight service integrator that own the logistic resources. So in some are 2PL and 3PL. In this case, the FSI can improve their position on the market by the services offered by Alcargo, because they know the logistic resources. The network-bound FSI currently are the FSI that organize the logistic services, try to coordinate using the networks and the partnership the services. In this case, this role will disappear in favor of the virtual integrator. The virtual integrator is the core and the key player in the Alcargo ecosystem, since it is able not only to coordinate a door-to-door logistic service, but at the same time it also is able to offer data about the environmental performance, is able to offer dynamic replanning, is able to offer monitoring and optimization services. For each of these possible reference business model, we have performed only a qualitative analysis of the possible evolution in the time of the market share of the profile. In case of the FSI, we can see that the asset bank integrator, that now are almost the majority of the market, will disappear because they will evolve going in direction of the LSP. We see that we have the network bank integrator that in the future will disappear because it will be replaced by the virtual integrator, that are mainly the ISI, so the actor in the AI ecosystem that is able to organize the complete door-to-door logistics service and also offers the information infrastructure. So, finally, we can take a general company and try to apply this approach to find out the benefits coming from Alcargo. We can take a general company, a connectivity provider. For example, this company offers connectivity services to port intermodal inland terminal. Mainly now, at the current state, this company is offering connectivity services, internet services, can deal with the data information about the private company inside the port in the inland terminal. So now, the value proposition what is only offering basic connectivity. The key activities is to manage the different data information of the company inside the terminal, to offer customer support, in case to offer support for the marketing of this company. The resources are mainly related for the human resources for the monitoring and the maintenance of the connectivity, for the connectivity services. The partners are mainly hardware and software vendors, and the customers are larger companies, also SME, directly presently in the terminals. The channels could be direct, some resellers network, and online. The customer relationships are mainly based on standardized procedures. And the cost structure is a fixed cost structure, also the revenue stream comes from fixed, some from fixed fees and some from variable fees. If we look at the evolution, the connectivity provider can evolve. it needs new resources, new devices, and also a new connectivity infrastructure. About the partner network, we have no change. About the customer segment, channels, customer relationship, cost structure, we have no change. But in this, about the revenue streams, we have a fixed subscription fee in order to have access, for example, to the monitoring services, and also variable fees, for example, related to the unit of cargo monitoring. So, in conclusion, this approach is considered the static part of the study of the business model, looking at the evolution of the business model in future scenarios, depending on the impact of an innovative solution, as for example the one proposed by Alcargo. It has been applied to study all the roles that compose the cargo reference value chain. As we can see, once a company identifies its role in the value chain, it's possible to apply this approach quite easily. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Valentina.